Hi everyone, welcome to Boxing Blocks and at the home of Nigerian African Boxing. Please, if you're new to the channel, make sure you click the like and of course the subscribe button right now. Bro, Diaz Junior fought and Joseph Parker fight was a very good fight. And yeah, the scorecard, bro. The scorecard 109-119. What do you make? Listen, okay, Joseph Parker defeated Junior fought via, you know, unanimous decision. A fight I think was a robbery, though, in my opinion. You know, it's a robbery. So because that 109-119 scorecard doesn't really make sense. But I don't understand the fact that I've heard that Joseph Parker versus Chizora might be his next, and Matruma trying to make that happen. That was even one of the reasons they zone kind of you know, got the right to head this bout and giving Junior Fa exposure as well. What do you make of the fight, brother?
Of the fight itself, it was a good fight, man. I was very surprised. Before the fight, I said, who's this Junior Fa guy? He's never fought outside of New Zealand, 19 and 0, but obviously there are bums because I don't know who any of them are. You know, Joseph Parker's just giving him the limelight, you know, to expose him. And, you know, that is a fact. Just all those things actually were facts. So I was very, very surprised by his performance. I was very impressed by his performance, you know. And at the same time, Joseph Parker did not look good at all. He did not look good. You know, he probably made Far look better than he actually is. I don't know. I'm not going to take anything away from Far's performance. But Joseph Parker did not put in a good performance at all. But the fight was enjoyable, man. I enjoyed the fight.
The 109-119 scorecard.
That's that. When I saw it was unanimous, my first reaction actually was, okay, Junior Fa's gonna win because it's unanimous. I thought if they were gonna try and give it to Parker, it would be like a split decision, and then Parker would get it. Do you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just because they want Parker to win. But when I saw unanimous, I thought, okay, Junior Fa's won this. But when bro, come on. 119-109. That's a joke, man. I don't know what fight they were watching, but that is a joke.
In my opinion, this fight was a robbery, though, in my opinion. Far should have won this fight, but I can understand the favor reason, you know, in boxing. This is one thing we'll talk about.
The only reason it looks more like a robbery is because of how wide the scorecard is. I think if the scorecards were closer, I would be able to accept it. But they were so wide that...
Far could have done everything, like landed more punches, and he still wouldn't be near. He wouldn't come near Joseph Parker in the scorecards. That's just...
According to the scorecards, they might as well have just written the scorecards before the fight started.
And you have to give Far credit, though. Like, the guy fought with an injury. Like, the guy, of course, sustained an injury during the fight, you know, blood everywhere, but
that's a boxer's injury. I'm not gonna give him credit for that, but what I will say is he's definitely gonna come again.
For a guy that hasn't fought at world level yet, you have to give him props.
100%. He did himself a lot of justice, and there's no way I can't see him coming again. Look, someone like Joe Joyce is already calling him up, right? So that's what I'm saying. He got the exposure, and he put in the performance, and now he's going to reap those rewards. That's why they always say, stay ready and take your chances. He's taking his chance, win or lose. When you put in a performance like that, you're gonna get your chances. And I'm pretty confident that guy's gonna get his chances now. There's people that are going to be calling them out because it's an easy yardstick to be like, well, this guy, you know, we kind of...
Far might surprise a lot of people. Like, this guy, by the time he starts training with a world-class trainer, like, I don't know his trainer. I mean, he's not world-class for sure. You understand? We're talking about boxing, world-class trainer. It's not. But imagine if Far were to, like, go to America and, you know, link up with a world-class trainer, bro, this guy would do wonders because I can see a lot of potential in him, despite being 31 years old.
With a little bit of UFC knowledge, I would disagree with the world-class trainer thing. Because Eugene Berman is a world-class trainer. But yes,
can you compare using Berman to Manny Robles, for example?
Because he hasn't done it in boxing, we can't.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I mean by work. I'm not saying the guy is not a world-class trainer in his own field, but boxing. Yeah. You know what I mean? We talk about boxing, yeah, bro. They sweet science.
That's fair enough. But look, we can't say anything about his camp because based on his performance, you have to say his camp have done a good job.
Because
these guys are nobody. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And to come and put on a performance like that on the world stage is very, very good. And he can only learn from those sort of performances, do you know what I'm saying? And kind of move on. So I wouldn't put too much emphasis on his camp, especially when, you know, his camp, the homeboys, they're in New Zealand. He doesn't have to travel to train. He can be going to the gym every day. You know what I'm saying? Like holding his craft, all of that. So I think he's in a good place. I think with more opportunities, we're really going to see, you know, what his potential is. But based on that first fight, you have to give the guy a lot of credit, man. Like, we have to talk about Junior Fa coming out of this and less about Joseph Parker.
Yeah, man, I'm a fan of Junior Fa, by the way, now. I'm a fan of Junior Fa. I would definitely watch every of his fights, you know. I think it's going to improve. You know, when you get to this stage, you automatically improve. That's just, I just hope he improves, you know.
And he has I think to improve be... after that fight. He can only improve. The first one I would say is go work on the stamina, which I'm sure he knows as well. Because he was saying, like, my volume could have been more after the fight. But the reason his volume wasn't more is because you knew that your gas was running low. Do you know what I'm saying? So even his stamina alone would really help him. Because if he can put in the same output in the later rounds like he does in the early rounds, it would be a difficult guy.
Yeah, definitely, man. I can't wait. So, guys, stay blessed, Thiago Stumbo. It was a very good fight. I liked it. God bless you all for subscribing and jumping on the live. You know, we're live for that. And it was good. Stay blessed, guys. Cheers.